The S-Play scheduler allows you to play back, pause, or stop playlists based on the time and date. For schedules to work correctly, your time and location must be set on the settings page. If we scroll down, we can see that this is set automatically, and my latitude and longitude are correct, and so is the GMT offset. So I'll head back over to the scheduler. Now think of a scheduler as someone simply pressing play, stop, or pause at the time that you've defined. As an example, I'm going to use schedules to turn on building facade lighting 30 minutes ahead of sunset and 30 minutes after sunrise. So here I'll type in the schedule name. Let's call it lights on. And that's going to be a play command. As I say, on the S-Play we've got play, pause, stop, play all, pause all, and stop all. So we're going to select the playlist. And we're going to set it to happen at sunset. Now we want the offset to be negative, as it's happening before sunset. I'm going to say 0 hours, 30 minutes, and 0 seconds. As we want this to be happening infinitely, we'll set the end date to be the same as the start. If you did want to have it happen for a fixed amount of time, you can define a repetition quantity. And the frequency type is shown on the top right hand side. So here we've got loads of options. They're not limited by what comes next. So for example, we could say per second and define 310 seconds for a playlist that's going to happen every 5 minutes, 10 seconds. Anyway, back to our example. In this scenario, I'm going to select weekly. Now we want this to happen every day, but let's say the club owner decides further down the road that they want to turn it off on a Wednesday. We can make this really easy for them by selecting every day now, but in future they can come back and simply untick a day. Finally, we've got the option to hide this from home. Now we're going to do this as there's no real need to have this on the S-Play's homepage. We're going to have this run in the background. Now I'm going to save. Now we can see up the top that this has produced a schedule. We've got the ability to edit it. We can see that the indicator's green. This means that it's currently active. If we've made it in such a way where it could have a repetition count, which could expire, once it had expired, this would be red. We can see its name, the playlist that it's controlling, its frequency, the time it's going to trigger, and then the scheduled start and end date. For this example, we're turning the lights on at sunset and off at sunrise. Now, as we've defined our location, the S-Play can automatically calculate the difference in sunrise and sunset based on the date. Now, as these times are changing, we're going to create two different schedules, one to turn the lights on and the second to turn the lights off. So to create another schedule, I'll go to the plus icon, type in the new name, and the command this time is going to be stop. I'll select the same playlist, and we're going to say sunrise. Offset is going to be plus, once again, 0 hours, 30 minutes, and 0 seconds. The end is going to be the same, as we want this to happen infinitely. And we'll select weekly, and tick every option. Once more, we'll hide this from home. Now, there we've got it. Two schedules that will automatically fade in 30 minutes before sunset, and 30 minutes after sunrise. Now to make this transition smooth, an extra thing you can do is navigate to the playlists. And as you can see here, on the playlist I've created a 25 second fade in and a 25 second fade out. If you've got any questions, feature requests or comments, definitely get in touch. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.